time management is obviously a really important factor in a PhD because you have so many different things to do and so little time to do it. But it's one of those things that often goes wrong. So a typical situation would be you feel like you're not getting enough done, you feel like you need to be more organized, so you make a plan, you timetable out your week or possibly several months, and it's all color-coded, so you've got all of the different tasks and you know exactly when you're going to do them. This gives you a temporary sense of control, but it's before you've actually done anything, so you feel better before you've actually done any of the work. And then once you actually start to do things, you find that this idealized timetable doesn't necessarily match up to reality because there are all sorts of unexpected things. So the timetable that you've done, it can become a burden that you're not living up to instead of a useful tool that actually helps you to make progress. There are a lot of different factors that go into effective planning. But one of the things that I think you should consider is this idea I've been talking about in some of my recent videos of decision fatigue. So the idea that when you have to make a lot of decisions in your work, then that's tiring. And the more tired you get, the harder it becomes to make good decisions. And then, you know, the more stressful it becomes. So if you're aware of that effect, you can start to arrange the different aspects of your work so that you're not doing too much of that kind of work all at the same time, or you don't have entire days or weeks where everything is this kind of exhausting decision-making kind of work. So if you have, for example, writing, which involves a huge amount of decisions, but then you have some kind of routine stuff, which is relatively easy. You have the knowledge and the skill and the experience to do it without really having to think that much about it because the decisions and the process are already set, then you can alternate between those two types of work. Okay. So for example, if you do 2 or 3 hours of writing in the morning when you're at your freshest, then if you have a break, if you go back straight back to writing, then perhaps it just gets more and more and more tiring. But if there's other stuff that needs to happen to help the writing, for example, inserting references into your document, which doesn't take that much thought once you've got the process, then, you know, you take a break from all that sort of decision-making stuff. So if you alternate between these two types of tasks, then, you know, it becomes much easier to actually sustain progress because you're not working to exhaustion, okay? So try it out. Try and factor in these two types of work, the heavy decision-making work and the kind of routine stuff, and let me know what you think in the comments below.